fans are coming, so we'll get back some more of Resident Evil 4. In the last episode, we met up with Salazar again, and we got sent down into the sewer area. And now, we are going to see what awaits us. But first, I do want to talk to him over here.
Things on sale, stranger. What are you selling? Come back anytime.
All right, let's do this. I'm actually gonna reload all of this. I'll take those. Let's go. Run. Just run. You almost got me. It's a power unit. Turn the power on? Yes. The elevator's power is back on. Please wait approximately 4 minutes for the elevator to arrive. The area must be locked down for safety reasons. I hope it's temporary. Open the shutter. It looks like it may not open for a while. Oh my God. Run! Go, 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 go! Okay, I'm gonna switch to my Magnum. You stay away from me. I was going the wrong way anyway. I could go right now, but I want to kill him. Crown jewel, nice. I'll take it.
It seems that Salazar is having difficulty taming the American pig. Salazar had his chance. Krausel, go get the girl. Oh, and dispose of the swine while you're at it.
Consider it done.
Nice. Another spindle. Wow. Luisa's Memos 2. The first Castellan buried the Lost Plagueis deep underground below the castle to hide their very existence. But when Salazar released the Lost Plagueis, no one thought he could bring them back to life, because when Salazar found them when they were all just fossilized remains, everyone knew that the parasitic organisms cannot survive without hosts, that they couldn't sustain life on their own. But when Salazar and his men excavated the remains, it almost appeared as if the Lost Plagueis were just waiting to be discovered so that they could resurrect. Several years later, unexplainable convulsions started occurring among the villagers who helped with the excavation of the Lost Plagueis. Then one day, all of a sudden, these villagers turned into violent savages. They later found out it was caused by the Lost Plagueis. Although they appeared fossilized, they were able to survive the long years by lying in a dormant state at cellular level, remaining in a spore-like form. Apparently, during the excavation, the villagers inhaled the spores within their bodies. The parasites became active again. This is how the Lost Plagueis were resurrected. Even as I'm writing, the excavation of the Lost Plagueis continues. God only knows how many of these Plagueis have been resurrected, not to mention the countless number of Ganadas that have been created. Their inhumane activity must be put to an end. If they are not stopped, people around the world could turn into victims of the crazy cult organization. Okay. Give me that. Thank you. Anything else? No? Are you serious? It's a lever to move the trolley. Hold a lever? Yes. Thank you. Oh my god. The power to the circuit breaker is cut. Turn it back on? Yes. Got him. There's money over here. I'll take that. It's a lever to move the trolley. Pull the lever. Yes. Got the dynamite. Nice. This boulder is blocking the path. Alright. Actually, I do have treasures. Put that in there. And put that in that. Okay. Looking pretty good now. Is that shotgun shells? It is shotgun shells. Awesome. Alright. Where did I come from? Because I want to save before I move on. I want to go back and save my progress. Right there. And that's going to be it for us. So here in the next episode, we're going to be heading into the room, which, spoiler, is going to have two giant El Gigantes, which I'm not looking forward to. especially since I'm pretty low on ammo at this point. But I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye!